This is Reentry 101, where I'm giving you the basic fundamentals of reentry for those that are coming home from prison, and I'm going to give it to you real and raw. You know, I used to have these certain beliefs when I was growing up, these certain things that I thought was right, and they was passed down to me as well from either older cousins or parents or aunties or uncles. And then as I got older and started going through some things, I started to realize, like, these beliefs ain't, you know, these ain't right. You know, and one belief I always had was that I was a product of my environment. And what I mean by a product of my environment, I'm talking about the type of environment that I grew up in, that I was raised in. And as a young age, I grew up in the projects, and the court that we lived on, nickname was Killer Court. So that kind of tells you what was, you know what I'm saying, what was going on right then and there, you feel me? And so I always seen things, hustlers, alcoholics, you know, drug addicts, and all this growing up throughout my life, gangs and things of that nature. And so I always felt like that was what my life was supposed to be like. No matter what situation that I was ever in life, whether I went to college or was playing basketball, I always felt like I was belonging in a product out of the streets. Like, I always felt like that was always in me. I felt like that's where I belonged. And so that's how I end up selling drugs and everything else and going to prison and everything. But then while in prison, after I've been in prison 3-4 times and I landed in federal prison and I'm starting to make the transformation, one of the things was I had to challenge them beliefs. I had to realize and look at there was people that grew up in the same type of environment that I grew up in. Their parents might have been on drugs. They might have had one parent, other parent might have died or whatever hardship that they've gone through. But we was growing up in the same area, same type of environment, and they never took that way out. They worked hard, they educated themselves, they got a vision, and they made it out. And they never became what we could say a product of their environment. So once I started seeing that, I started realizing that I'm not a product of my environment, that belief was false. That's what you're going to have to do now that you're out or on your way home. You got to challenge some of them beliefs that are holding you back. Challenge your beliefs. I need you to write down 3 beliefs that you believe that you are, now you're on your way home or now that you're out. Write down 3 beliefs. Do you believe that the PO is a babysitter? Do you believe that you just ain't going to make it? I need you to write down the 3 beliefs. And then what I need you to do next is write down ways that you can change them 3 beliefs. Because you got to challenge your beliefs. Because your beliefs will lead you to prison, and it'll hold you back once you get out of prison. Even like the PO situation. Like, you know, I used to feel like I didn't need no PR. I'm grown. I don't need no babysitter. But then I came to understand that if I got expectations for myself or something, then I will understand why there's a PO in my life while I'm on probation and parole. You know, so challenge your beliefs. That's what it's all about, challenging your beliefs. This is, hold on, challenging your beliefs. This is Reentry 101.